In today's session, we will be discussing about how to design a pizza order form. This is a sample pizza order form that we will be designing. Now, before going to the designing part, I want to share one thing with you. That is, whenever you are told to design a web page, sometimes you may require to have a particular color. So the colors which are inbuilt or default, it's easy for you to recognize and use them. For example, red, green, yellow, purple and all. But sometimes your designs may have some colors which you are not able to identify because it may be a variation of a color. So to exactly identify the color or to exactly identify some font, you can go for the use of extensions. Okay, so if you just Google out Chrome extension to pick font, you will get a number of extensions. Out of that, you can just check out which has a good review and you can install that extension. For installing an extension, for the people who don't know how to install, you just need to click on it. And if it's a new extension, it will be added. Now, font picker, I have already added to my Chrome. So it is telling me remove from Chrome. But say, for example, I go for font finder. And this is a new extension, so I can add it to the Chrome. You just have to click this button and it will add the extension to your Chrome. So once it is added, you can see the extensions in your address bar. So here all these are the extensions. When you click on this, you can see whatever extensions have been added to your Chrome. Okay, so now I want the color of this form. That is, what is this color, particular color, because I'm not able to identify it. So I'll just go to the extension. I will click on my extension called as Color Zilla, and I will once again go to Color Zilla. It gives me a message, a drop down list, sorry. Then I'll select color picker and it is not able to identify the color now. Picked color history we will check, but it is showing me the previous one. Now, as this image is not clear or it's not a part of web page, that's why it's not able to pick the color. Okay, see, now you can see the color has been picked up. So I'll go here, I'll go to Color Zilla. Sorry, I'll go to Color Zilla this side and I'll go to color picker, and now you can see that it has picked up the required color. Okay, so I'll just keep it open because we want to use it. So now we'll go to our editor. I will create a new file. We will save the file. Let me save it in our XAMPP folder. So go to your XAMPP folder. Inside that, go to htdocs. In that, say for example, I'll create a new folder called as assignment 6. Okay, and inside assignment 6, I'll create a new file called as pizzaorder.html. okay, now in this I'll create an HTML file. We will give the title as pizza order form. Now when we come to the body tag, we will give the background color. For this, either you can have a separate CSS file or you can write this styling in the tag itself. So I'll give BG color is equal to, and we will copy this color code. Okay, so here I can get the hexadecimal code of the color. I'll copy this and paste it. So let us first check if we get this much part. For this, I need to run my XAMPP server. So again, I'll go to the XAMPP folder. Inside that, I will select XAMPP control. I will start Apache and MySQL. And then I'll go to my browser window and click localhost slash the name of my folder is assignment 6. So now you can see I have got the background color. Okay, so this much part we have completed. Now let us move on to the next part, that is designing of our form. So I can guess that this is H1, that is a header. So let us take a header over here, H1, and it is italic. So I'll take the I tag and we'll write down pizza order form / I / H1 and a break. Okay, so save the file, go to your browser, and okay, so I can see that it is coming as pizza order form, but it has not been centered. So you can add a style to your H1 in this, or you can add another file and you can add your CSS there. So I'll show you how to do that. So let us, a good practice is keep your designing part separate and your HTML separate. Okay, so let us go to our folder. And we will give our name to the file as pizzaorder.css. Okay, so this is my styling file that I will be using. Now, how do you add a style? Now, I want that this header should be centered. Okay, so I'll go over here. I will tell the CSS file that wherever you encounter an H1, the align, the text alignment should be centered. Okay, I will save the file, but I need to link this CSS file to my HTML file. So for that, we make use of link tag. So link style is equal to pizzaorder.css. Okay, so this tells my HTML file that the styling file for this particular HTML is pizzaorder.css. So find the styles in this particular file. Now I'll save my original file. I'll come here and I'll refresh, but there are no changes that I can see. So something is missing. Let us see the link style sheet in HTML. So let us verify so the tag is link, relation is style sheet, and href is okay. So we will change this. Okay, so relation is style sheet and href is pizzaorder.css. Okay, so we have created a new pizzaorder.css file. We have connected it to our pizzaorder.html file, and now we go to the browser and check. So now you can see that it is coming in the center. One more thing, that if I compare this form with this, I can see that the font is different. So either you can try out your own fonts, that is try out different fonts till it matches with this one, or you can make use of your Chrome extension. So let us see if my Chrome extension of font picker can identify the font. So okay, it won't identify the font for this because it's the font which is not a part of HTML page, but it's a part of your image. So extension would not help in this point. So you can just Google out Google fonts. Okay, and you can go to this website of fonts.google.com, and here you can see number of fonts. Okay, so here you can match out which font matches with this one. So somewhat similar font we will be using. I think this would match with this one. So let us try and use this. That is Rubik form. Okay, so you can just go over to here. And you can select this style. So you can either embed this form, or you can write the CSS rule like this. Okay, so better we'll copy the CSS rule. We will go to our editor, go to CSS file. In this we will add this particular rule, but this is to be added for body. Okay, so in entire body, wherever the font will be used, it will be this font. So I'll just remove it, add it over here, and save. Okay, now let us check whether our font style gets changed. Okay, you can see that it is somewhat similar, not exactly similar, I can say, but somewhat similar to this. Okay, now we go to the next line and design our second line, that is customer name and a text box, phone number and a text box. So we'll go to our pizzaorder.html. Here I have to write customer name. Okay, and then I'll have to take a input box. So input type is equal to text. Size you can give as 20. Okay, let us check whether we get this much part in our browser. So we'll go step by step. We can also make use of a div over here. So div name is equal to form. So our entire form will be in a div. Okay. Slash div. Or you can make use of a form directly also. So I'll take form name is equal to order. Okay. And slash form. Inside this we will be designing our form. And this same style we will apply to our form tag also. So I'll give body comma form. Okay, so let us save and check whether the style gets applied to this. Okay, it's the same font, the only difference is it's not bold. Okay, so if you want, you can give extra styling for the form. That is like this. For the form, you can set text size as 15 pixel, not 15, 20 pixel, let us say. Let us go and check. Let us inspect if there is any error. Text align is, you can have it as justify. Okay. Okay, next we will take phone number. If you want, you can change the size also. Say for example, if I take 28 pixels, text size is not getting applied. Text size is not applicable over here. So let us give the size to this. Okay, next we will take customer phone number, that is phone number. If you want, you can make this bold. I'll copy the same thing. Phone number. Save the file, go to the browser, refresh and check. Okay, so I'm getting customer name and phone number. If you want some more spaces between them, then for spaces you can make use of and then BSP. Okay, so function F5. Okay, so this is how you have designed customer name and phone number. If you want to increase the height of the text box, you can give the height attribute. Next, we come to the second part. Now, this second part is a table. Okay, so let us design a table now. I will be requiring how many columns? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 columns will be required. And the number of rows are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 rows we will be taking and 5 columns. Okay. So let us have table. So I'll be taking a table tag. Now let us go row by row. Okay. Now first row is my heading. So here you'll have pizza image, pizza choice, quantity, unit price and total price. So these are the headings. So let us start with our first row. Okay, so I'll give a tr. In this I'll have the first header, that is pizza image. Okay, next we go to the next line and take the second header, that is pizza choice. Next we go to the third header, that is quantity. Next, we go to the fourth column, that is unit price. And we go to the next column, that is total price. Okay. So, this is how you can add headers. Let us go here and refresh our form. Oh, we need to align the table. So, we'll go to our CSS and we will align the table. So, table. Let us check for alignment. Align content to center. Or align self, sorry. Not content. Otherwise, our content will be centered. But we want to align the table. So, align self to center. Okay. Save the file. Go here and refresh. But there are no changes. Let us give the property over here and check. Okay, so it is coming now. Let us give 2 or 3 breaks over here and refresh and check the file. Okay. Now we move on to the next row. Now, next row is I want to add images. Okay, so one image. So I need to copy this image, but this entire thing is an image. So we'll better go to Google and search for some pizza images. Go to images. And just download some of the images. Go to your folder. So I'll go to my folder which I have stored in this XAMPP folder under htdocs. So I'll go to htdocs, search for my folder, and then I'll store it as pizza1.jpg. So currently I'll download the same image and use it in all my rows. Now this is my first element. Of the second row, it's not a header, it's a data. So I'll take TD. Okay. So td slash td. Inside this, I want to add the image. So I'll write image src is equal to pizza1.jpg. Also, I need to give the width and height. So I'll give width as 100 and height as 100. So let us see what kind of output do we get, and then we will check. So go to our form function fi. So you can see that I'm getting a pizza image. If you want, you can increase the size of the image. So let us take it as 200 by 200. Save the file, go here and refresh, and you can see that I'm getting my pizza image. Now next is pizza choice. So in pizza choice, I'm having a checkbox. So second data element that we need to add, that is td. In this, I need a checkbox. So I'll type input type is equal to checkbox. Okay. And value is equal to big Italy. Okay. And I'll will have slash input. So in the second column element, I have taken a checkbox. Okay. And here you can type big Italy. Save it and cross check whether you are getting that much output. So function F5. Okay. So I'm getting it as big Italy. Next is quantity. In the quantity tab, we are having empty text box. So I'll go to the third column using td, and inside this I want a text box. So I'll write my input type, where input type is equal to text. Okay. There is no value. Size we will give as 20 and slash input. So this will create an input box. I'll refresh the page. You can see now I've got the quantity. Then we have unit price. Okay. Quantity should be little smaller. So I'll just change its size to 10 and go and refresh. Okay. Now it's quite good. For unit price, I have 12.00 written in the text box and it's a read only. Okay. So we go to the next column using td. In this, I again want a text box. So input type is equal to text. Then I have value is equal to 12.00. Okay. And it's a read only. So I'll write read only, save and cross check. Okay. So I'm getting unit price as 12. One more thing, we need to give a size. So let us give a size is equal to 10. Save and refresh. Okay. So I've got this. Then I go to the total price column. For total price, I'm having a disabled text box. So I'll be taking a text box, but it would be disabled. So I write again td for my last column. Now again I type input type is equal to text. There is no value. Size we can give. Size is equal to 10. And we'll use the property of disabled. So save this and go to your file and refresh. Okay, so you can see I'm getting total price and it has been disabled. Okay, so like this we can add other rows as well. So what you can now do is, once your a single row is ready, you can just go to the next row, or you can just copy this row and paste it, and you just need to change the values. Okay, so I'll go here and paste it. I'll keep the image source same. Okay. If you want, you can change the size of the image. So let us make it a little smaller as 150 by 150. Okay. So 150 by 150. And we will just need to change the values. So it is meat lover and 10.00. So we will change it over here. Okay, rest of the things will be same. Again, I can copy that same row, paste it and change the values. So it is veggie lover. Okay, unit price was 9.5. So we will change this to 9.50. Save your file, go to your file and refresh. Okay, so now you can see there is, okay, it was 200. Let me change it to 150. Okay, save this, go and refresh. So now you can see that almost my form is ready. The last part that is remaining is total order. Okay, so for my next row, I can copy this row, or no need of copying. I'll just have a new row. Inside that, I'll be having blank cells for how much? First, second, third cells are blank. So I'll have TD slash TD, TD slash TD, TD slash TD. So first three columns are blank. For the fourth column, I'm having the word as total. And for the fifth column, I'm having an input text box which has been disabled. So I'll just copy this from here and paste it over here. Save your file, go and cross check what is the output. So you can see that I'm getting a total. If you want, you can make this as bold. So either you can add it in, if I want everything, every column's value to be bold, I can just go here and set the styling to TD, and the style can be text decoration. Text Okay, let us check the property for TD. TD property, TD CSS property for bold. Okay, so font weight is the property. So we'll go here, we'll write font weight and bold. Okay, save it, go here and refresh. So you can now see that I have got everything as bold. So this is how I have designed the form till here. Now the last part is remaining, which is having two buttons. So let us take those two buttons as a part of our row only. So we will have our last row. Now in this, I'll have TD. We will use the property of call span is equal to 2. Okay. And in this, we will be taking input type is equal to submit, value is equal to calculate order total. Okay, and slash TD and slash input. Let us check, or we need to add a text in between. Okay, so function F5, I'm getting calculate order total. Okay, so if you want this to be bold, then you can just go here and write give the styling for input as again font weight. Let us check if we have font weight for this. Font weight is bold. Okay, save this, go here and refresh. Okay, so I'm getting calculate order total, which has spanning, which is spanning. Okay, total columns we are having 3 and 2, 5. Okay, so now let us add our second button in our same row. So I'll just copy this and paste it on the next line, and we'll take the value type as reset button, and the text to be printed is clear order. Okay, so this is how you can save. go here and sorry, not here, to our form and refresh. So you can see I'm getting clear order and calculate order total. Okay, but since we have spanned it, or else you can do one thing. If you want a single row, it's not looking that good. So what we will do is we will span all the five columns and we will end the TD at the last. Okay, so let us see what kind of output do we get after doing this change. So save this, go here, function F5. Something missing. My mistake. I wanted to delete the TD and I deleted the input type also. So go here, function F5. Okay, so here you can see that I'm getting my two. We can give a class to this and then we can give the styling. So let us try it out. Class is equal to btn. To this also we will give class is equal to btn. Now whenever you are giving a class, for those who are not able to recollect, if you assign a class to a particular element in HTML, then that class can be used for styling that element. So how do you define a class? If you are directly using the element, you can give the name of the element. Now if I want to use a class, I need to give a dot. So dot btn is my class, and to this I want to give the styling of width. So width I will set as 100 pixels. Let us see what happens. Okay, you can see that the width has changed. Now let us change it to 300 pixels. Even you can set the, okay. So this is how you can design. Instead of this, we'll take it as 200 and refresh. Okay. So this is how you can design a pizza order form.